What's up, guys? It's Brian, and we're here talking about the song The Final Countdown, legendary rock song. And the most important thing I can teach you with this song is this right here. Drummers, if you can master the little stick twirl, okay, you're on your way. You can hold it here, do this, up in the middle, it's a little more challenging, okay? If you can manage to whip it between your fingers and stuff, I'm not that good at it. But, fun thing to practice while you're waiting for the band to, you know, big synth intro, you can just be chilling, okay? Now, the drum beat is pretty much the same, you're playing the same part the entire song. And normally, when you're playing with a band, you always want to listen to the bass player, and you want the bass player to be listening to you. And you guys want to figure out how you can really lock together. So if you listen in the recording, the bass player is doing this kind of rhythm. Jump, 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 jump. Okay? And I didn't catch it at first, but actually the drummer is kind of playing along with the bass player with his bass drum. Okay? So the beat the drums are doing is something like this. I'll play a little bit slower. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? He's catching some of the jump, 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 jump. All right, here it is at the tempo of the song. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. If that's a little bit too tricky for you, it's totally acceptable to just keep a four, what we call four on the floor. All right, you're just gonna keep your bass drum going on every beat. It'll sound like this. 1, 2, 3, and. Okay, kick and snare. My kick is just doing 1, 2, 3, 4. Snare is on every other beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so. The thing that I'm thinking about, since the snare and bass drum pattern is the same exact thing, both the verse and the choruses, we want to think, okay, how can we still treat this song with some dynamics? We still want the chorus to feel strong, and we want it to stand out, which means I need to do something in the verses that brings the energy just a little bit down, okay? So what I would do is, in the verses, I would keep the hi-hat not completely wide open and slushy like it is in the choruses, but I would keep like a slight pressure or even closed so that it's not as washy, right? So what I would do in the verse is something like this. 1, 2, 3, and. Or, if I'm playing the simpler drum beat, I would do the bass drum just on the first and third beat. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And the snare, same, 2 and 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Together it would sound like this. Okay. Then when it gets to the choruses, definitely let those hi-hats loose. All right, let them move around, wash around. It'll sound like this. 1, 2, 3, and. Okay, Also, if you're playing the simpler beats, definitely have the bass drum driving every single beat. Okay? One, two, three, four. But with the hi-hats open. And that'll help kind of make sure the chorus feels like the energy is coming up. And it'll keep, yeah, just some dynamics. It's very important, especially a song that's so repetitive like this one. Other than that, there's a lot of these kind of, you know, big drum fills that happen. And there's a couple different ways you can do this. The easy way would just to be just using your hands. And it's like a 1-2, 1-2, 1-2 snare, okay? Sometimes you can start either on the toms or you can start on the snare, okay? I'll demonstrate both ways. 1, 2, 3, and. Okay, or if I start on the tom. Okay, if you don't have a third tom, just play your low tom twice. Okay. Another way you can do it, it's a little trickier, but it's gonna be 1-2 with your hands and a 3-4 with your foot. And with the foot, it's a little tricky because it's a little fast, but if you can get it down, it's super cool. So I'll play it slow. It sounds like this. Okay. The most important thing is to try and leave everything rebounding. You want to let the sticks and the bass drum pedal like bounce off the head. And that's how you're gonna get those doubles fast and easy. Cool. The last thing I wanna point out is this drum fill that happens leading up, like going into the guitar solo. It's this big 2-bar break, and I'm sure I completely messed it up in the playthrough, but I listened to it, I wrote it down, all right, I got my little cheat sheet, piece of cardboard, and I'm gonna break it down for you right now. Side note, if you ever have an opportunity to learn how to read music, read rhythms, do it, because it's a lifesaver. All right, so here's what we got. I'll break it up, I'll break it into the two parts, all right, these two bars. Starts like this, 1, 2, 3, and okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 1. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, right? So three groups of two. And then just a single snare drum by itself. 1, 2, 3, last time, and. Okay. So, the second part, it's tricky, guys. It's tricky, okay? Be patient, you'll get it. Here we go. I'll start with the second part. Starts with the snare and tom together. 3, 4. Okay, one more time. 3, 4. Okay, so we got 1, 2, ba 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 da ba ba 2, and again. And boom, boom, ga, 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 da, ba, ba. Okay, now let's try and put both of those bars together. Looks like this, 3 And okay, I'll do it a little faster because when it's really slow, it's kind of hard to feel the rhythm of it. So let's go a little bit medium. One, two, three, and. Okay, a little bit faster. This is the song tempo. One, two, three, and. All right. Again, it's funky. It's weird. If all you can do is some random, you know, snare break, go for it. Without looking at the paper, I'm just going to improvise something right now. One, two, three, and. Okay. Anything in that kind of broken up feel will totally work. But yeah, there you go. That's honestly, that's it.